Mark Thiam, originally from Senegal, runs this Afro shop in Saint-Louis, France, where he sells African foodstuffs and other essential goods, as well as offers services including photocopying and printing. Even though his business stayed open during the pandemic lockdown this past 8 weeks, he says he has lost a lot of revenue.
I was forced to open due to the nature of my business. Food is a priority. Despite being open Monday through Saturday, my sales have still dropped. I lost my Swiss and German clients due to the closing of the border.
Daily, over 300,000 cross-border workers commute into Switzerland from neighboring countries like France, Germany, Italy, and Austria. But with the coronavirus pandemic, borders in the Schengen area have been shut, like this one that connects Saint-Louis, France to Basel, Switzerland, only open to essential workers.
Across the border in Basel, Switzerland, Eka Parr from Nigeria has not been so lucky. His business isn't considered essential, so it has been closed for several weeks.
No income, and then we have been paying a lot of bills. So it's actually a very big, it has a very big impact on our business. We used to cook daily. The vegetable, all the vegetable we bought, all of them got spoiled.
Almost all countries closed their international airports and borders as part of measures to check the spread of coronavirus. This means shipping of goods from and to Africa has been suspended. In Germany, Ekenedike, a Nigerian who imports and exports used vehicles to West Africa and Eastern Europe, has been out of business for weeks.
In the history of my business, I never feel so bad the way I feel this time around. With all this movement because of this lockdown, nobody is coming out. Everywhere is down.
Madi Sakandi has same story. His refrigeration business based in Italy cannot ship vital products to his home country, Burkina Faso, and other African countries.
We cannot produce our system because our customer, main customer who are using our system is the industry. Most of the industry has closed. Then it's very difficult for us now.
Although some European countries, including Germany and France, have started easing lockdown, there are still many restrictions and guidelines. African businesses operating in Europe are adjusting to the new safety standards. Nana Zimmerman, a Ghanaian, owns one of the largest African shops in Basel and Bern, Switzerland.
There is a plexiglass between the customer and the salesperson. Not more than 10 people can be in this 300 square meter store at once. And also, if they are waiting for their turn to pay, they have to keep their 2 meters distance from each other.
Like here, this position, maybe we will have like four seats or seats so that the customers will not sit next to each other.
If the customer comes into your office and they find out that he did not wear any mask, the customer has to pay 150 euros penalty, and you, the owner of the company, have to pay 24,000 euros.
Andrew Schweizer, member of the Swiss Africa Chamber of Commerce, says,
"We must say that we must advise our members to look into the situation in Africa very closely, and to decide how to do business in future or how to help. Because what we can say is, you know, in Switzerland, it is very, at the moment, it's very easy. If you have a business, it's very easy to get money from the state. You just fill a form, COVID-19 form.
80% of the company has a problem, a cash flow. Cash flow, we don't have cash flow, so it will be a very big problem to restart.
Governments in Europe are activating various financial support for economic effects of the pandemic.
We also had a little support from the government where they granted us a 10% annual sale loan.
The government has promised aid of 1,500 euros per month. Unfortunately, many will find it difficult to continue their business.
African business owners, like business owners across the world, fear for the future of their enterprises post-COVID-19.
watching ANN.